listeners, let's learn how to safely and carefully put together your oboe. So you can see I have my oboe case here on the right side of my chair, all right? And I've made sure that it's right side up so that when we open the lid, nothing will go spilling out, all right? So if you've double checked that, then it's right side up. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna open my lid, okay? And before we do any building, I want you to find your cork grease. Might look like a little tube of chapstick, or sometimes it comes in a little container that you screw a little bit off of and you have to kind of rub your finger in it to get some. Okay, mine looks like a little thing of chapstick here, okay? The goal of the cork grease, or its use, is to obviously go on the cork that's on your instrument. You'll see a piece at the bottom of your bottom joint, and you'll see a piece of cork at the bottom of your top joint, okay? And that cork is there because that's where our pieces go together, and it's there to make a pretty tight seal so that the pieces don't just drop off, okay? We have to keep it moist so that it's easy for us to put those pieces together. And also, if that cork dries out, like if you ever hear a little squeak when you're putting together or taking apart your oboe, that means your cork is too dry. And what can happen is if you keep applying that friction when we twist and push to push the pieces together, it will start to create little rips or tears in the cork, which eventually the cork will fall off your oboe, then your pieces won't stay together, then you can't play your oboe, it needs to go to the shop so they can replace the cork, all right? So this is a little bit of maintenance, maybe use it, you know, once every other day. That should keep your oboe pretty well maintained, okay? So I'm gonna take the lid off here. I'm gonna grab my bottom joint, and I just like to do a couple swipes kind of around the cork, and then I like to use my finger to get rid of any of the clumps, so it's just a nice thin layer. It's not gonna be a lot, otherwise it will start to gunk up on your instrument, okay? Then put that down, pick up the top joint. You've got a little piece of cork down there as well, same thing. Just gonna use my finger to spread it around, and then easy peasy, it should be good to go. Put your cap back on your cork grease and put that away so you don't lose it. I like to keep a Kleenex or something handy to wipe it off. Otherwise, when you try to put your oboe together, things can get a little slimy. All right, so one more step before we build. You need your water container. And I filled mine up about a quarter of an inch to a half of an inch of water. You do not want to fill up your water container all the way because the only part of the reed that you want to soak are the blades or the wood of the reed, okay? We don't want to get the thread wet, we don't want to get the cork wet, otherwise that cork of your reed will swell and it will get stuck in your oboe when we try to take it out, okay? So, I've got my water, let's get a reed out of our reed case very carefully. And then I'm just gonna very gently, you don't wanna slam it into the bottom, place it in my water. And then I'm gonna leave it sit because by the time that I build the oboe, your reed will be ready to soak, okay? About 1 to 3 minutes, okay? You don't wanna soak it anymore, otherwise the reed gets waterlogged and it actually gets too soft, okay? So you kinda have to be like Goldilocks. You don't wanna soak it too much, but you don't wanna soak it too little either, okay? So 1 to 3 minutes. Okay, all right, so I'm gonna grab the bell, which is, in my case, it's in the middle. It flares like a little bell, right? Notice on your bell, you have one key. I'm actually gonna use that pad. I'm gonna press it down when I put the bell together with my bottom joint. You can see when you press that, it raises. See that little piece of metal that's above, kind of sticking up above the top of the bell? Okay, well that piece actually has to go over another little piece of metal on your bottom joint. So that's why I like to, when I put this on, go ahead and press that pad down so that it raises it. That way it won't be running in to the piece of metal, okay? All right, so I'm gonna grab my bottom joint now as well. Notice on your bottom joint, if you look where the cork is, that little piece that sticks down, kind of flat, looks like a little stair, okay? That is the piece that the bell little bridge has to go over, okay? So you can kind of see that's going to match up and go over that little piece at the bottom, okay? Now, just be careful of your bottom joint. You see these keys that stick out pretty far. You've got these over here stick out to the side. You've got at the top, you actually have a few things that stick out. The these big long pinky keys. Be very careful. I know we think metal is pretty strong, but the metal of these keys is actually quite delicate. If you were to squeeze it really hard, it can bend, which will mess up the mechanics of your oboe. Okay, if you were to like rest it on something, or if it gets stuck in your case when you close the lid again, it can damage, bend that metal. So just be very aware. On the back, you'll see your thumb rest. Okay, we'll talk about that later when we get into hand position and holding the oboe. And then look at the top here, you see, you see two more little sets of stairs that are gonna have to connect to it as well. All right, so when I hold, we talked about holding the bell, put your thumb down on that pad. When I hold the bottom joint, I hold it towards the bottom, okay, kind of over these rods. Again, I don't wanna press on any of these keys that stick out so I don't bend them, okay? Now what I do is I kind of offset that little key, the little stick metal on the bottom, and I'm gonna push the pieces together as I twist, okay? So I'm gonna push and twist at the same time, and then once you have the gap gone, again, I have to make this piece on the bottom, on the bell, go over that little stair step. So just twist it until it's aligned. And it should be pretty straight and aligned there. Okay, remember, the bell piece goes over that piece of metal on the bottom joint, okay? And then that means now that the bottom joint will talk to the bell with that key, okay? All right, so now we have to put on our top joint. And again, be aware, now you have two little bridge keys here that we have to meet up. And again, these flat parts, okay, are going to go under the piece on your top joint, okay? So hold that in one hand, pick up your top joint, and again, if you just look at the bottom where the cork is, you can see kind of how those pieces are gonna line up. So again, the pieces down here are gonna go over pieces on your bottom joint, okay? And the keys should all go the same direction as well, okay? We don't have keys on the front and the back. That would really be quite difficult to play, okay? So I'm gonna look at my thumb rest here on my bottom joint, and I'm gonna look, if you look on the back of your top joint, you only have one key too. This is called the octave key. Okay, so that's kind of how you know the back. The keys are facing towards you or away from me. Now on this one, I'm gonna hold again at the bottom of the bottom joint, and I'm actually gonna hold more on the top of the top joint. And for this one, I'm gonna do short twisties back and forth as I push. You can't just twist the oboe all the way around because otherwise these little keys on the side, they will run into each other, okay? So short little twisties as you gently push down. And again, those bridge keys should align. The top joint pieces going over the bottom joint pieces, okay? All right, and just make sure they're totally in line there, okay? And that is your oboe, okay? Excellent. We have one more piece to add, and that is your reed. I pick up my reed gently, handle it by the cork. You can shake off the excess water or like a straw, excess out, and then this goes into the top of your top joint, and you want to make sure that the blades, okay, are flat to the